This week on Above Par, we're kicking in the Palm Desert enclave of Bighorn Golf Club, where the rich and famous live and play. What better place to pursue the above par life?
You know, I'm old school, man.
We'll tee it up with the original gangster himself, Fred the Hammer Williamson.
To me, golf has always been a stupid game.
Really?
Yeah.
I'll vibe with the area's top architect, learn a thing or two about a revolutionary set of wheels, and connect with a Bighorn member who personifies the spirit of giving.
Getting cancer for me was a blessing. It gave me a determination to make a difference.
So roll with me, Dub B. Together, we'll be living life above par. I'm Wyeth Barker, better known as Dub B. As a producer and performer, my love for music has taken me to the industry's biggest stages. My career is my passion, but ever since I could walk, I've also been immersed in the game I love, which is golf. And I was groomed to compete on golf's biggest stages. So now I'm putting them all together. Come and join me as we live it up at golf's finest clubs, where everything exists above par.
From the club to the tee, come travel with Dub B. I'm dealing what's never seen. Pitch red, green, fairway dreams. Bring it all to reality right here on Above Par.
If the game of golf had a desert home, it would be Palm Springs. And no golf community better represents the spirit of the area than Bighorn Golf Club. Today, we're digging in to experience firsthand what all this hype is about.
Bighorn, baby. Above par, live in Palm Desert. Come on.
From the immaculate clubhouse to the locker rooms and pro shop, the facilities at Bighorn are no doubt above par. Instructor Tom Stickney divides his time between Bighorn and Colorado's Club at Cordillera. Not a bad gig if you ask me.
Yeah, we have the Fazio course over here. It's called the Canyons, and we have the mountain course designed by Arthur Hills.
Which side has the most treacherous greens?
Ooh, that's a good question.
For a view from the inside, I sat down with Bighorn's boss himself, Mr. R.D. Hubbard.
How would you describe Bighorn's personality?
I guess a lot of people would say it's my personality, but the only rule we have at Bighorn, you can play 10 people if you want to, okay. But the only rule is that you don't hold anybody up.
Right.
It's no secret the above par lifestyle goes hand in hand with fly whips, and European Desert Motors turns them out in style. But even amongst all these sweet rides, a totally new age sports car caught my eye.
I've seen nothing ever like this.
Haute couture on wheels, right?
That's what you gotta do. So Karsten, who is the buyer of these vehicles?
It is an individual who does not have to ask for permission. This is a male buyer, but women get it, because this is all about the bling effect. This is all about the right materials, the best materials.
And that's why you come and showcase a car like this out here. The C8 Spyker Aileron. Just sounds beautiful.
Above par, stick with us. We'll be right back. The Bighorn lifestyle goes beyond the club and courses to the surrounding community. It's a true desert paradise. The creative brain behind many of these lavish cribs is architect Christy Hansen.
I would say almost everything that I see inspires my work.
So does the environment of the desert and the climate in the desert, how does that affect the creation of the home?
The desert environment primarily, which allows people to want to be outside as much as possible. And I think creating those outdoor living spaces is primary in what we do.
What is your future?
My future, I would tell you that what we have done in the last 2 years has so far surpassed anything I ever thought possible that I'm not sure what the future holds, but I'm really excited about it.
Christy's vision really left an imprint on me, just like she's left her impression on this whole valley. Beautiful.
You could paint it better.
Exactly.
One of my favorite places to eat in the desert, right on Palm Canyon Drive. Las Consuelas Terraza. Let's go have a margarita.
The tournament first started.
Really?
All the guys used to come there.
Fred the Hammer Williamson earned his nickname as an NFL defensive back. When he retired from football in 68, he turned his hand to acting with countless movie roles, including MASH, Original Gangsters, and Dust Till Dawn.
Ain't nothing but God.
I was blessed to parlay with this professor of old school cool.
You gotta look good to play good, you
right.
know what I'm saying?
Right.
Hitting the ball and playing golf really ain't no big deal, man. I mean, it's just golf. Look at where that pin is, man. I mean, it's like, it's daring you to go at it.
Well hit. You're dancing.
Supposed to turn, though, man.
You're dancing. Did you do the wiggle?
Listen, I'm going to have to use colored balls, man. These white balls ain't doing it for me, man. You know what I'm saying? I put some doo-doo on it.
And there you go. Oh, good roll, though.
Dude, you got a jinx on me, man. Dog.
You know?
Play that hard to tally, man. I'm a senior citizen, man. You're supposed to be doing that.
There you go.
And it ain't in the bushes.
It ain't in the bushes.
It ain't where yours is. I went to Sears and Roebuck and bought me some clubs.
There you go.
And I went out every night for about 6 months, man. Just played golf in the dark. Just, you know, I invented a swing. So that's how I started playing golf, man. I got invited to a celebrity tournament. I got embarrassed that I wasn't doing well, so I started playing golf. Now I'm addicted.
You're addicted?
Know? Well, it's a sickness. It ain't a game.
Well, how many times a week do you play now?
I play Hammer People once a day, every day, all day. Is that thing legal?
Hey, you know what? Ask Phil.
Hammer time.
Just like that. You don't even need to look.
I don't never look.
You already know it's good. Here, you want me to grab it for you?
Did it say booger, looker, looker, looker?
It did. Give me an excuse. That's all I need is an excuse. I'll take it. You see what he did to me?
Bighorn Golf Club is about more than just the game. It's about big hearts. Sure, the people here have a lot, but they also give a lot. And that spirit of giving comes alive each year through the Bighorn BAM. But what's a BAM?
Bighorn BAM started with a group of ladies that play golf and wanted to make a difference in this community. In the 2 years that we've done this, we've raised almost $700,000.
$700,000?
Yes.
And BAM donates it where?
We donate it to the Lucy Kirchy Cancer Center and the Bighorn Radiation Oncology Center, which is at Eisenhower.
Eisenhower Medical Center? Mm-hmm.
Thanks to Selby, I scored an invite to a soiree on El Paseo, the Rodeo Drive of Palm Desert. This fundraiser attracts plenty of bling, and all for a good cause. They say it's go hard or go home, I'm still here, I'm still strong. Been around the world, got blown. With the best of both, and in defense of them, we all elevate our minds, ain't no stress in the air. So find pressures and pain, trying to stay sane. Hours by by, time ticks away. Still holding on to the past, knowing that moments last. Watching all the sand slowly trickle down the hourglass. Fridays or some rain, while Hollywood wants some gunplay. What about what the... It's hard to imagine a more complete experience than my time here at Bighorn. The courses, the community, the people, and the play. We've set the bar high here at Bighorn Golf Club, but we'll be back, and we won't disappoint. So keep your scores low and live your life above par. Until next time, this is Dub B.
Above par. Here we go.